Welcome back to the channel, guys. We're going to take a look at installing the Epic, Ubisoft, and Origin launchers here onto our Steam Deck. They're all the exact same process, so I'm really only going to show you the full process with Epic. I'll show you a little bit with Origin, and by the time we get that far, you already know how to go through and do Ubisoft. And it's the same process I showed back in my Battle.net video as well. As a matter of fact, most Windows programs or apps you're going to install on your Steam Deck do this exact same process over and over again with not much change. So in this video, you're going to see how to get your Proton compatibility layers you're going to need. I'll show you how to add custom artwork so your Steam Deck doesn't look like a mess with all these non-Steam games added in, and also how to use your SD card as storage, among other things in this video. So even though it's a little bit longer of a video here, I want to pack in a lot of information to try to help you guys out as much as I can and make it easy to understand how this process works. So let's go ahead and get into it, starting with our Proton compatibility layers. So you can see me here, I've opened up Discovery app and I've searched for Proton, which gives me Proton up-qt. If you don't have this installed already, make sure you install it because you're going to need to get really used to using this for the compatibility layers. I'm going to go ahead and launch mine here and get this ready to go. You can see I've already got 20, 24, 26, 27, and they've released a new version 28 while I was making this video. So I'm going to go ahead and install that here and use it as well. So I'll click install for that and it'll automatically install it into Steam. I'm going to speed this up for us a little bit, but this is how you want to add your GE Proton compatibility layers to Steam so that you can use them in your launchers, your other games, and you're going to want to have numerous versions as well. You want to get really used to using different compatibility layers to run different games and apps depending on how they run. Sometimes it's not always best to use the newest. But anyways, get used to using that. You'll need to use Proton up-qt and get used to using those compatibility layers. The other thing you want to do is make sure that you can see hidden files or folders on your Steam Deck. So you click your little three-line tab up here, show hidden files needs to be selected right there, and you'll be able to see all the like grayed out or hidden files because you'll need to access that to get into your local data. Now, the other thing is you can see here in my downloads folder, I've already got all the media I want to install into my Steam Deck for custom artwork. And I already have all of my installers for Ubisoft, Epic, Origin, and Battle.net downloaded here ready to go. But of course, very simply, use whatever browser you prefer between Microsoft Edge or Chrome. Go to what website you're wanting to download from, whether it be Epic, Origin, or Ubisoft. For us here, it's going to be all three. And then you would go and do your download just like you would over on Windows with your browser. So you would click on that, get it downloaded, and it should go into your downloads folder. Make sure you always know where all of your downloads, your installs, and everything are going, especially if you're not really used to the Linux setup, so that you can always find them. And now that I've got all of my installers downloaded, all the media that I'm going to want to use, I've got my Proton compatibility layers ready to go, we're going to go ahead and start with installing our launchers. And we're going to start with Epic and, like I said, go through the full install with that. So this is all going to be done with Steam. So I'm going to go into my Steam library and very simply, we're going to start the process. And like I said, this is a very rinse and repeat process to install these. Now, I already had everything installed with Origin, Ubisoft, Battle.net, Epic, and all of those. I've uninstalled my Epic just so I can more clearly show that full process here. I'm going to leave everything else installed and we'll kind of overview that. And also go check out the Battle.net video if you want to see that. It also goes through this full process again with that. But it's the same thing here. So we're going to go to add a game, add a non-Steam game. I'm going to go to browse and now I'm going to go in here to my downloads because that's where we've put all of our launchers. Now, you want to make sure that you click all files here. This will often default to something else so you won't see everything. So you want to make sure you always have all files there. I'm going to go through here and find my Epic installer, which there it is right there. So I'm going to click on my Epic installer. We're going to open that. And then we'll click add selected programs because that's selected up there. Now that's going to add the Epic installer for us right here. Now we're going to want to go into our settings. I just use the GE Proton right off the bat. And I'm going to start off with the newest layer. So we're going to go in here and we're going to change the compatibility to force compatibility and we'll use that new layer. But what you'll see here is the new one that I downloaded 28, it doesn't show up yet. It's because we haven't restarted Steam and I left it that way on purpose. As soon as you restart Steam, it'll show up. So if your layers aren't all showing up there, make sure you restart. So we'll go ahead and click play here and this will go ahead and open up our installer. It'll go through its little bit of process here. I'll go ahead and just let it go real time so that you can see the install process here and then we'll speed some other things up. But it'll work just very much like it would be on your Windows PC. It's running through the Windows compatibility layer here with GE Proton. So I haven't ever had any problem with any of the four or five launchers I've tried installing and having this work. So once it gets done, its process, we'll be done with the installer, and I'll show you how we move on from there and add our actual exe file to launch our launcher. So once that's done, it should just kind of stop and be finished. And once that happens, we can now remove this from Steam because we're done with it. So I'm going to right click on there. I'm going to go to manage and remove non-Steam game. I don't like clutter, so once I'm done with something, go ahead and get rid of it. Now we do again, same process, adding non-Steam game. We're going to go to browse, but this time we're not going to downloads because we've already done the installer. We need to go to where that has now been installed. I'm going to click all files here, and what we need to do is go to home/deck. We need to go to local, share. Then we're going to go find our Steam folder. Should be right down here. Then we're going to go to Steam apps. And then we're going to go to compat data. It's a folder that we'll find up here. This is the exact same path you'll go every time for every one of these launchers. The difference is when you get in here, you're going to have these numbered folders. Low number folders are system or Steam files. You don't need to do anything with those. The long numbered folders are all Windows programs that I've installed, and they'll always show up that way. So you need to go find the folder that is your Epic Games launcher or whatever launcher you're doing. For us, it's Epic. I happen to know it's this folder right here for today. So I'll click on that folder, then we're going to go to PFX, Drive C, Program Files x86, Epic Games, Launcher, Portal, Binaries, Win32, and then we're going to scroll down until we find our Epic EXE file for our launcher, and there it is right there. I'm going to click Open, Add Selected Program, and you'll see it pop up over there. Now we have the ability to get into our actual Epic Games. And just like before, we want to go into Settings, Properties, and we're going to go to Compatibility, and I'm just going to go ahead and use the newest GE Proton I have here for myself. That way we can go ahead and get this launched. Now there's a lot more we're going to do with Epic, but I just want to go ahead and get this started, get signed in and everything, because when you first launch this, you're going to have an update, you're going to have sign in and all that kind of stuff. Once you do that, it'll just launch you right into your normal page just like this. So I want to skip us past that and show you what's going on here. So I've got that ready to go. Now, if you want to install a game on your SD card, simply go to your Dolphin Manager here, go to the bottom for removable devices, go to primary. You can see I'm looking at my storage here now on my primary external storage. Now I'm going to go ahead and add some folders here because I know I'm going to install games from Epic, from Origin, from Ubisoft. So it's just easier while you're here. Go ahead and add what folders you want to add for game installs. It's easier than just letting them install wherever they want or letting the launcher make its own files. I just find it's often cleaner and it's easier to find this as well from the launcher, which I'll show you here in just a second. But now we've got all those ready to go. It's just going to be easier for us to go ahead and get our install. Now see our path here at the top for our primary. You're going to need that information if you want to be able to launch and use this information from your SD card. So I'm going to go ahead and stop the Epic Games launcher so I can show you here. I've already got the command line ready to go, but you guys will need to put this in here. So I'll open up properties down here at launch options. It's going to be Steam_compat_mounts equals, and then you have that path I just showed you. You're going to need to put your path in there, and then space %command %. That will get you the access that you need for all the launchers. You're going to need to put that in all of the launchers that you install. So if I go to click to install the game now, I can change from my standard C drive. I can click over here and expand my computer. I can come down to E, and you can see the folders I created for Ubisoft, Origin, and Epic in here. So I know this is my SD card. It's never really labeled as SD card, and it's not always E. It could be something different for you. It does change here. Now, these are like my system folders. These I don't need. But it's another reason why I like to have those folders pre-made, because when I click on a letter, I'll see and know for sure that's my SD card. So I'll click on Epic, and I'll be able to install a game right there if I want to. Same exact process for all of the launchers that you'll install here. Origin, Ubisoft, Epic, whatever. Same exact thing. So I'm going to go ahead and finish stopping this. Now, if you want to add in your custom artwork, there's quite a few places you need to go ahead and put it in, and you might have to experiment with sizing a bit and downloading different pieces of artwork. But if you go into your settings here and click on your empty icon space, I'll go in here and grab up my Epic thumb I know works here, click on that, and it puts a little custom icon there for me. Now right here in this empty space, if we want to set a custom background, same process, I'll click on that, I'll get into my downloads, and I have things labeled here for that. Now again, you may need to adjust sizing, you may need to download different images, not everything will work perfectly. When you switch over to game mode on your Steam Deck, if something is still grayed out or not showing, you may need to make some changes, and I'll show you what that looks like later as well, but it just helps keep things look a lot cleaner. You can go in here and rename this as well, so it's a little bit cleaner, so we'll just call it Epic Games. And then there's another spot we're going to want to go and put in our media as well. So if I go to library, there's recents right here. You can see it's grayed out again. We're going to go ahead and add artwork there. Now, sometimes it doesn't quite work right here. And there's another spot. If you open something else and Epic Games moves over and it's that shorter, more narrow icon, you might have to click it and add it again. For it to show up on your Steam Deck, I've noticed. But it does tend to work. If I get all the media placed in all the right places, it will work out. And I'll show you that when we get over to the game mode on the Steam Deck, how all of my media is laid out. But this should be helpful for getting you started with adding in the pictures and getting yourself going. You've got your launch options down here, so you can use your SD card if you want. And we're fully ready to use our Epic Games Launcher. That's the full process. And it's the same exact thing over and over and over again. So if I wanted to do Origin, I would just go in here and same thing, add a game, add a non-Steam game, go to browse. First place I have to go is my downloads, because that's where we've downloaded our installer, right? Make sure that we have all files selected. And we'll go and we'll find our Origin installer, which is right here, originthinsetup.exe. So I'll click that and we'll click open. We'll click add selected programs. And I'll scroll down here and Origin should be showing up for you just like Epic did for us. And like I said, this is just literally the same process over and over again. Sometimes some paths and things are different, but there you have it. So we would just go in here to our properties again. We would go to compatibility. We would do our Proton layer just like we did in Epic. We would be good to go. And then we would go ahead and run this to install it just as we did before, which I don't need to do here because I've already got it installed. Then we would remove the Origin setup like we did before with Epic. So I would go in here to manage. I would go to remove. Now I already have Origin there, but if it wasn't and we were doing this the first time, we would once again go into add a non-Steam game, go to browse, and then you got to go find that numbered folder again. PFX, Drive C, Program Files x86, Origin. I'm going to scroll down. Make sure you have all files selected if you don't see what you're looking for. And then we're looking for our origin.exe. Paths may be a little different here or there, but you're always looking for your launcher's .exe file so that you can launch that from Steam. So here it is right here for our Origin. We'll click open. We'll click add selected programs again here. Well, I don't need to because we're already in there, but you would do that and then you would have Origin ready to go. You can see this is a very rinse and repeat process. You're doing the exact same thing over and over again to install all of these. And then of course I would go in, I would change my compatibility to my newest here. I would go to my shortcut. I would make sure I have my launch option in here for my SD card access. And same thing. I would go do the same thing over and over again for Ubisoft or for Battle.net. It's all basically the same process. And of course I already have my Ubisoft installed and ready to go as well. And all the custom artwork and options and compatibility layers all done here as well. So you would go through those same adding a non-Steam game processes we just went through. You would get to this part. You would do the same thing. You can see I have my launch options down there for my SD card. I have my compatibility layer. Same thing. They're all set up the exact same way, and they were all installed the exact same way. So if you can install one launcher, you should be able to install them all. Now over here on game mode, you can see all of my media has been inserted properly for all these, so I don't have just grayed out little boxes. I have actual icons and media and stuff that matches as I go here. So very useful and clean to be able to do that. One thing, if you go into controller options, somebody has made an Epic Games controller for Steam Deck. Works great. You can use the touchpads to click and the controller to play the games. And it's always good to go in and look at different controller options and types. People have made a lot of good things that work for these different launchers and even some cloud gaming and stuff. So anyways, running Epic here on game mode here on the Steam Deck runs just as well as it does on desktop mode. All the three launchers run really well between Ubisoft, Origin, and Epic. The only game I have installed right now is Crysis 3 Remastered. I'll go ahead and load that up and run that while we're finishing out the video. But guys, this should have given you a really good idea on how to do everything you need to do between your Proton compatibility layers, how to use your SD card for storage and installing games this way, how to get all the media where you want it to make things look clean. And like I said, it's pretty much the same process, except for maybe a couple of paths to the EXE file or whatever here or there. It's just basically the same process over and over and over again to install Windows apps and the launchers and stuff here. It's definitely the same process for all four launchers between Battle.net, Ubisoft, Origin, and Epic. So, and all of them have been running great for me on deck, even in game mode. Everything's been really, really good. Just running Crysis here has been fantastic. No stutters or problems. Decent frame rate with low settings here. And other games, whether I'm on Origin or Ubisoft, I've just had a really good experience with it. It may not be the easiest thing, it is kind of workaround, but once you get used to it, you can do these installs in just a few minutes. You can install your games, and while not every game performs perfectly or runs, it's pretty good. It's surprising how good the performance actually is with these and how well it works. And once you install a couple of these and you go through this process a couple of times, it will become second nature to you. Learn the file system, learn where everything is, and you shouldn't really have any problems. But anyways, thanks a lot for coming to check out this video, guys. A little longer than I anticipated, but there was just kind of a lot to show and talk about in here. I'm hoping it answers a lot of questions when it comes to installing these three launchers and other programs as well on your Steam Deck that are Windows-based. So thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, if you haven't already, subscribe, thumbs up, ring the bell, leave your comment, and I'll see you guys in the next one.